In this video, we derive the change of base formula, and we do the following four problems and check them. This is part 14 of Logarithms. We're going to go over what we call the change of base formula. Here's the problem. Let's say I'm trying to figure out what the log base 2 of 11 is equal to. There's a little bit of a problem here because I can estimate this answer, right? So I'm thinking 2 to what exponent is 11? Well, 2 cubed is 8, so 3 is too small. 2 to the 4th is 16, too big. So I know it's 3 point something. But how am I going to figure that out exactly? Well, we could try to use a calculator, except that we don't have log base 2 in the calculator. We have log base 10, the common log, and we have natural log, which is log base e. So we have to come up with another strategy. Let's say, well, let's call this n. We don't know what it is, right? So we're looking for what this log of 11 base 2 is equal to. Let's just call it n. Now let's change this from logs to exponential form. So I have 2 to the n equals 11. Still a little bit of a problem. What I'm going to do is take the log of both sides. Now we take the log of any base, the same base on each side. So let's just do log base 10. So I'm going to take the log of 2 to the n. That'll be the log is equal to the log of 11. Now I could have used the natural log, but what I do want to use is a log that I have on my calculator. So I'm going to use just log for now. And now by doing that, this n in the exponent could come out to the front. And that's the key. Anytime you're trying to solve something where the exponent is a variable, we want to take the log of both sides, and that allows us to get that exponent down. So this gives me n log of 2 equals the log of 11. And remember, log of 2 is just a number, so we're just going to divide both sides by the log of 2. And that will be, that's what n equals to. So what I really ended up with is that n, what I was looking for, was really just the log of 11 over the log of 2. Now notice that is not the log of 11 halves. I actually have to get my calculator out, use parentheses, etc. I have to figure out what the log of 11 is, figure out what the log of 2 is, and divide it. This is the exact answer, okay? That's the exact answer for the log of 11 base 2. Okay? Now, what if I had done this problem slightly differently? Let's say instead of taking the log of both sides, I took the natural log of both sides. So let's see what happens there. I'm just going to take the natural log of both sides. Then I'll have n times the natural log of 2 equals natural log of 11. And again, remember, natural log of 2 is just a number, so I'm just dividing both sides by the natural log of 2. So this is also equal to natural log of 11 over the natural log of 2. And in fact, you could do the log of any base. But I'm choosing either just log base 10 or natural log because I really want to put this in the calculator to get an approximation. So both of these are exact answers. This is an exact answer, that's an exact answer. I could do log base 5 of 11, log base 5 over 2. I'm sorry, the log base 5 of 11 over the log base 5 of 2, etc. You could have any base, but I want to use something in my calculator. So now we need to put log of 11 in the calculator and log of 2 in the calculator, either both logs, base 10, or both natural logs. So try that in your calculator and see if you can get an approximation, let's say, to the nearest, let's go 4 decimal places. Now, if you have a scientific calculator, usually these keystrokes at the bottom will work, whether you use natural log or log. You just put in the numerator 11, and then natural log or log divided by 2 in the natural log or log, and then the equal sign, and you should get 3.4594 if you rounded it to the nearest 4 decimal points. All right, now, that's sort of what we guessed. Remember that? because 2 cubed was 8, 2 to the 4th power is 16, we want to get 11, so this seems reasonable. And in fact, in your calculator, if you put 2 to the 3.4594, you will get a number that's close to 11, not exactly 11. So, because remember, we are rounding here, you're not going to get it exactly 11. Okay, so now let's do this in general. So we've got, what about if we have log of a base b? Well, I want to know what that's equal to. So the question is, we're trying to find what it's equal to. Let's say we're looking for n. So I'm going to write b to the n equals a, and I'm just going to use natural log of both sides. Or in fact, to be really general, I'm going to say, I don't care what base you're using, so let's call it log base m of b to the n equals log base m of a. So in other words, I would probably use just log, which is base 10, or natural log, but you could use anything. We bring the n out to the front, log of b base m, and then we divide both sides by log of b base m. So this n that I'm looking for actually equals log, now I could use any base, so that's why I have the m, base m, over the log of b. So check it out. It's the log of the a divided by the log of b. Now, remember, if you use base 10, you'll just write log of a over the log of b. If you use natural log, it's natural log of a over natural log of b. So if you're going to use your calculator, of course, you would use one of those. And so that is the change of base formula. So here it is. I'm going to just write log a over log b, any base you want. So this is the change of base formula. So here are three problems for you to try. You're going to use this change of base formula, and you could either use the log or the natural log key on your calculator. So put the video on pause and approximate each of these to 4 decimal places. All right, you could either use natural log or log base 10. So I just wrote possible things you might write down, and then I did the computations in my calculator. Now, you should make sure that these make sense. So let's see how you can possibly check number 1. So we have log of 20 base 3 is approximately 2.7268. So to check, let's see if 3 to that exponent is close to 20. That's, we know it's not going to be exactly the same. So now you could use your calculator to compute 3 to the 2.7268, and let's see what we get. I've got 19.99927, you know, it goes on and on and on. So yes, it's this is 19, sorry. It's pretty close to 20. So that looks like that's a good approximation. Now let's do number 2. So the question is, what's 1/2 to the negative 4.1699? Let's see what happens when we put this in. And this is going to be approximate because I can't go out all the decimal places. Be careful that you're putting in negative 4.1699. You'll have to use that little plus minus key in your calculator. And I get 17.999688, you know, a few more. So yes, that looks like it's about 16. And finally, let's check number 3. So let's do 4 to the negative 0.1315. We want to see if that's going to be about 5/6. So remember, 5/6 is about 0.8333. So let's see, we're going to put that in the calculator. And using my calculator, I came up with 0.833333, and that is close to 5/6. These are the keystrokes I used. I put in the 4, That's the base. Then the y to the x to show you're going to put the exponent as. Now, you want negative 0.1315, so I first have to put 0.1315 and then that little plus minus key, and then I press equals, and that's how I came up with the answer. All right, so just make sure you practice using your calculator and that you know how to check your answers.